Today on the show, we shall be looking at five reasons why Godwin Obaseki will be re-elected as the executive governor of Edo State come September 19, 2020. Join us for this interesting conversation. I'm your host, Michael Ongel. Despite the presence of other candidates, the Edo election is expected to be a two-horse race between Godwin Obaseki of the PDP and his main challenger, Pastor Osiagie Ezeyamu of the APC. Coincidentally, both men slugged it out in 2016, with Obaseki, the then candidate of the APC, having the upper hand. 4 years down the line, a lot has changed in the political landscape of the state, with Obaseki having a major fallout with his estranged political godfather and former governor of the state, Comrade Adams Oshomole. How will the pendulum swing this time around? Here are five reasons why I think Obaseki will be re-elected as governor. Number one, power of incumbency. As current governor, Obaseki enjoys what we call the power of incumbency. He has control over commissioners, local government chairmen, and some members of the House of Assembly, which he will definitely deploy to his advantage. Secondly, his first-time performance as governor. According to findings, Obaseki has performed above average in his first time in office. He has initiated projects that is aimed at improving investment and human capital development of the state. He also initiated the Gelegele Seaport, the Benin Industrial Park, the modular refinery, amongst others. Number 3, Adams Oshomole's removal as APC National Chairman. The removal of Comrade Adams Oshomole as the National Chairman of the APC will most certainly work in Obaseki's favor. This is because Oshomole no longer has the influence he commands when he was chairman of the APC. Number 4, Ezeyamu's personality. The controversy surrounding the personality of Pastor Osiagie Ezeyamu, candidate of the APC, may work in Obaseki's favor. Videos have emerged showing Oshomole describing Pastor Osiagie Ezeyamu as a cultist. Finally, sympathy vote. Most Edo people will vote for Governor Obaseki because of the general belief that politics of godfatherism has no place in the South State. Now, the pendulum standpoint. The odds are in favor of Governor Obaseki ahead of the September 19th election. It is expected that INEC, the police, and relevant bodies will provide a level playing ground for a free, fair, and credible election. That's the size of the program for today. If you enjoyed this video, please like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel at Yans Nigeria. Until next time, when I come your way, stay safe and thanks for watching.